Good morning. So it's about 9:30 today here at the hotel. We're packing up, we're ready to go on the next thing. And Michael, can you tell us what we're going to be doing?
Yeah, so the first half of the day, we're going to be meeting with Bari again. She's going to take us to the Kibera slum, where we're going to meet people who use different types of cook stoves, ethanol, charcoal, biofuel. So it's going to be a great test for us today. And then the second half of the day, we're going to be doing a travel towards the Maasai Reserve, which we're going to go visit tomorrow. So a little bit of a visit, a little bit of a travel today.
I don't think you can get packed any more in this taxi. We just made it to the Kibera slums. Right now the game plan is to go out and meet some people who are eventually going to be using our product. It's really different out here. But hopefully we're going to meet some really awesome people today and get some conversations going. So yeah, it's going to be cool. How are you feeling, Ryan?
I feel good. I really, really am looking forward to seeing what people think of our generator and how it can improve their lives.
Hi, I'm Michael.
David.
Good to meet you, David.
Pleasure.
Paul.
David.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
Fina. Michael, good to meet you, David.
Good to meet you, too.
Paul.
Fina.
So yeah, we just had our first meeting. Michael, how'd it go?
That went really well. So we met with the people from Safi, and they make ethanol stoves that people use here in the slum. So right now we're in the Kibera slum. So we're going through, you can see all the little shacks on the side maybe from the peripheral, and we're just about to head into one of the homes so we can see how people cook firsthand. So that's up next, and then we're going to meet up with Ryan and Maureen, who are taking photos and video from another part of the slum. So
yeah,
that's the plan.
Absolutely. So.
Outside, but today is dry.
Okay. Yeah. So this is the house, and you can see. So in Kibera, most of the communities are using this.
Yes.
Yeah. Most of the people are using JikoPower for cooking. Some are using stove.
So we're about to take off, but we're gonna switch rides. From the taxi to the van. How are you feeling, Michael?
Good, hungry. But okay. It's been a great trip.
We've
gone to meet a whole bunch of awesome people. So it's been a great, great morning. So it's only gonna get better.
They're crazy.
It's only gonna get better.
We just finished lunch. And now we're gonna take off. 4 hours. we met this great guy named Frederick, who we gave one of our generators to, and he's a really nice guy. And hopefully we'll meet up with him later. But for now, we're saying goodbye. This is our van. 4 hours in here. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. So right now we're just driving, and we're seeing a bunch of awesome markets and things like that. Just going crazy with the pictures back here. Super cuddled up in marine.
Ooh. 2.5.
I wouldn't rather be in the back of a van with any of
them.
Okay, so we're driving through the valley near the Masai Mara tribe, and the sun is setting, and it's absolutely gorgeous out here. It's just stunning. Yeah, you can't, it's hard to put it into words, really, but it's definitely something to experience. Yeah. It's stunning.
Yeah, it's been, it's a once in a lifetime experience.
Okay, so we just made it to Narok, and we're just heading to our hotel now. It's only about 7 o'clock in the afternoon, but it is dark outside. It's real dark. So I'll let you talk to you guys after we get to our hotel. So we made it to the hotel safely. It's a great hotel. The staff is really nice. And we have Ryan here, who's going to talk about what impacted him today, what he saw out there in the slums, and what we're going to be doing tomorrow. Ryan.
Thanks, Paul. So today we had the opportunity to visit the Kibera slums, which is the largest slums in Africa, potentially the largest slums in the world. So more than 1 million people living there on less than $1 a day. And so we were able to meet many local people and introduce them to the JikoPower Spark and get their feedback and insight as to how the JikoPower Spark could impact their lives. And it was a really incredible experience. We were able to validate many of the assumptions that we had had, that, you know, that the majority of the people living there own cell phones, but the majority of people living there have a difficult time keeping them charged. And so they could really benefit from what we're doing. It was a real eye-opening experience for all of us. And I think we're more impassioned than ever before. Tomorrow we have a big day planned. We're going to go visit the Maasai tribe, and we're going to see how the JikoPower Spark can help them as well. So be sure to check with us tomorrow. Thank you.